When we think about the concept of creation and craftsmanship of anything, there's often an argument between two sides happening just below the surface. In movies, it's film versus digital. Cars, fuel injection versus carburetor. In music, hardware versus software. An argument I stumbled upon by accident while watching a beat-making video from the YouTuber Craftmaster Productions. I took a long hiatus from making beats and decided to watch other producers to get my inspirational juices flowing. Well, I was listening more than I was watching because I was also doing push-ups. CMP had been working on a melody for about 20 minutes, getting the sounds just right. Then, something strange happened. I heard a metallic click, and the melody all of a sudden sounded like something from my childhood. Like I was watching one of my old VHS tapes with my favorite shows. And I scrambled up from the floor to hopefully get a look at the screen before he minimized whatever program he was using. I thought it was too late because the screen hadn't changed. I looked closer and saw him fidgeting with a blue and white metal box. Is that a guitar pedal? The melody warbled and hissed more and less. So I typed in the chat, "Bro, what kind of guitar pedal is that?" After a short delay, he read my comment and smiled, like he almost didn't want to answer. Then he looked in the camera and said,
"This ain't no regular pedal, bro. This is a Chase Bliss Audio Generation Loss."
I was blown away. I wanted to run the melodies for so many of my throwaway beats through it. This was a magic box, a blessing for hip-hop producers all over the world, like an Instagram filter for your melodies. And you could own one, if you could find one, and if you had $900. I did not have $900, so I finished my push-ups, and I forgot about it. Until 2 weeks later when I was watching another CMP stream, and it happened again. A simple, regular melody turned to pure magic. I had to type some salt in the chat. If I could only afford to spend a mortgage payment on my awful beats. CMP replied, "Loser." Chase Bliss is a small company, but they make other pedals. What?
Bruh.
I was invigorated. I couldn't wait to hear them all. While I was doing my deep dive, I found out that lo-fi and trap producers had been using these pedals for a few years. And a plug-in with a similar sound had come out called RC20. It was significantly cheaper, and your melody could get all the flutters, warble, hiss, and remain stereo. The young producer swore by it, so I checked it out. It was cool, real cool. But the software didn't give me the same feeling as the Chase Bliss hardware. Not even close. CMP's whole tribe was ordering Chase Bliss audio pedals left and right and posting pics in the Discord. I had to have one. I found a used Dark World reverb pedal for a few $100 and pulled the trigger. It came in a few days and I drove myself crazy running melodies, vocals, and sound effects through it. And I wondered something. Did the company know the huge impact the pedals were having on the hip-hop world? I decided to reach out and ask a few questions, expecting to hear back from a rep with some canned responses. Turns out I heard from the man himself, Mr. Chase Bliss Audio, Joel Corty. And he was happy to answer my questions about the future of the surprising relationship between Chase Bliss and rap producers. Here go a few of the questions I asked.
Okay.
And I'm gonna do his voice too. I'm gonna be both of us, because that's what the budget say do. Our community is running the melodies for our beats through your pedals to age them in interesting ways. We heard about the Generation Lost collab first and started racing to create the most unique chain. Did you know hip-hop producers were using your pedals? Yes, I'm a massive hip-hop fan, probably my favorite genre at the moment. I've been absolutely delighted to see my pedals more and more in beat-making contexts. We designed them with that in mind. You have affected guitar-based music and movie soundtracks in such a profound way. Any plans to do vocal effects and be a one-stop shop for singers and songwriters? That's a really interesting idea. One of my favorite pedal companies, Old Blood Noise Endeavors, made a really, really good vocal effects unit called Maw that I don't think I could top at the moment. That said, I think all of our effects are pretty well suited for vocals as well as guitar and other instruments. Any plans to do stereo pedals or rack mount versions of your circuits? Yes, absolutely. We just released our first stereo pedal, CXM 1978, in our Automatone line of pedals. We plan to do more stereo pedals with that line. Regarding rack units, there are no plans to do that. I love the way you and your team handled the reverb pedal release situation. It favors guys like me who just want to manipulate sound. Since CBA is a boutique company, your stuff is sort of rare by default. Any plans to discourage the scalpers of tomorrow? Thanks. That was a tricky situation. I've learned that at least for now, I'd like to stay away from limited releases. The Generation Loss is an exception to that because Cooper FX is planning to release a new version of that pedal that will have many of the same features as our collaboration. Because of that, it just doesn't make sense to make more of our unit because it would interfere with the release of the new pedal. What's the difference between the mood and the blooper? I am confusion. It's a question we get a lot, so we made this blog post to help explain the differences. Link in the description. Alright, now this last question is long, so I might make y'all read it. But follow along with me, man. I had an idea for a circuit and I had the pedal goat on my line, so I had to ask him. See if you can picture what I'm describing. There it is, a peek into the future of the pedal company that's changing the way we make beats. What Chase Bliss pedals or other pedals are you using to make your melodies and loops sound interesting? All my partners going crazy with the different combinations. What a time to be a tribe. Appreciate y'all for watching The Nerd from the Hood. I am 607, and I'll holler at you in a little bit.